From the minute I wake up, I'm always trying to present the best version of me. Whether it be my hair, my makeup, my face, my body, even to what caption to write on this selfie, it's never ending. And it's not just me. More than ever before, young people are feeling the pressure to be perfect. So where is this pressure coming from? And when did being Little Miss Perfect become the ultimate prize? To find out what's driving this perfection pandemic, I'll meet the people going to extreme lengths for the perfect face.
I just want to look plastic and fake looking.
The perfect body.
I had uplift, lipo, and I felt like I needed that to feel better.
And the perfect life.
I think people think it's perfect. We only share the things that we choose to share.
I'll learn how social media and advertising is driving our obsession with perfection.
We're comparing with celebrities and influencers on social media whose lives are just manufactured and calibrated to generate likes.
And I'll challenge myself to celebrate my own imperfections.
When I used to be called hamster cheeks when I was younger.
As I dare to drop the filter and attempt to embrace my flaws.
Look at them. Bloody having their own postcode.
Meeting the imperfect models who've learned to love the skin they're in.
What other agencies might consider a flaw, that's their selling point.
And joining them for my own bare-faced photo shoot. So for the next 2 weeks, I'll dare to bear the real me as I go filter-free. It has given many of us a complex. Dubbed the Zoom boom, cosmetic doctors and plastic surgeons have seen a drastic rise in bookings for facial treatments. But what I want to know is what actually makes a face perfect. Dr. Julian De Silva, a Harley Street cosmetic surgeon, thinks he's found the answer.
Hello, Hayley.
Hello.
Dr. De Silva, pleased to meet you today.
And you?
Demand for his work has skyrocketed after he developed a way to measure booty to help him recreate the perfect face for his clients.
So, Doc, why are we so obsessed with how we look?
Since the beginning of time, there's always been like a search for what is beautiful. Mm. And all of us recognize like a beautiful face, but how can we measure it?
Yeah.
So I developed a tool analyzing the human face based on the golden ratio. And so golden ratio, well, we know from Renaissance times, it's been used in paintings to define beauty. Using that same principle, we can apply the golden ratio to a human face, and that will give us an objective measure of beauty.
The golden ratio is a mathematical equation commonly found in nature and often used to create beautiful art and architecture. By measuring various facial features, Dr. De Silva has discovered that the closer they are to the golden ratio, the more perfect the face.
Taking a human face, you can broadly define 12 objective measurements. So one could be the eyes, one could be eyebrows, the nose length, the lip proportions. Taking those measurements, you can compare them with the golden ratio, which is a ratio of 1.618, and we can get a percentage of how close that is to perfection. So in a way, it's difficult to choose one characteristic on the face and say that one characteristic will make a person beautiful, because it really is the sum of all the different characteristics. We applied our tool to a whole host of like celebrities, and overall, when we did this, Amber Heard came out top and scored 97%. The proportions of her nose are very elegant. The length of her nose compared to the width of her nose correlates very closely with the golden ratio.
Me up. Oh my days. Well, that's not a good photo.
Well, the good news is you scored really highly. You scored at 87% overall.
Really?
Which is really good.
I always thought I had a fat face.
You have a beautiful face. You have like volume in the cheekbones that make your face look more feminine.
When I used to be called hamster cheeks when I was younger.